Nippon Ichi Software, your America department, seems like you might have a little internal conflict going on, because over at NIS America, one of your localizers apparently said that Japanese humor is sexist. Yes, I have to censor myself on this platform for certain things. I apologize. But that's exactly why I built up my own website as well. The whole article is on Nyanet without the censorship. It really is annoying to talk about censorship and have to censor myself. But again, that's why I've taken steps to not have to do that in other ways. Link in the description for that article. I'm going to tell you what it's about, though, in this video. But yeah, pretty funny. NIS is a Japanese company. They have the NIS America department. And their localizers pretty much insulting the rest of the company over in Japan. Isn't that wonderful? And not just insulting the rest of the company, of course, also pretty much insulting Japan and also their consumers. Because guess what? Guess what? This is going to be shocking, I know. But your consumers like the product the way they are in Japan. That's the appeal to us. So do you really want to be calling us these buzzwords or implying that we are such? I don't think so. Probably not a good idea. Before we continue, though, I actually have a really cool discount going on with Teespring. Our Teespring agent contacted me. Very nice person. Love working with her. She's giving us 10% off, a 10% off discount code on all of our merchandise here. And the cool thing is, it doesn't come out of my profits. It comes out of Teespring's profits. So very nice of them. If you are interested, the discount code's on the screen right there. It is Flurries, but you replace the E with a 3. And no, that's not Furries. That's Flurries. Like a flurry of anime attacks or something. All right, now we're over on the Nyanet. Let's get into the rest of the news. Also, let me mention the discount code and the Teespring link. They're in the description as well. So you don't got to worry about having that screen cap or anything. Anyways, here's the article. And we're going to start with this tweet from Raging Golden Eagle in regards to this anime Stars Align. We have a little bit of a recap here regarding companies that, well, you know, didn't really see much success with Mavirtue signaling. Let's just put it like that. RGE had a nice little comment there about that. 21,901 retweets, 55,730 likes. So let's stop right there a moment and admit, yeah, that's great engagement. 21K retweets, 55K likes, that's great. But here's the thing, that doesn't translate to sales. They still had to stop production. He writes, such a financial flop, it got canceled halfway through its planned 24-episode run. Take note, corporations, social media likes / retweets don't equal sales. This crowd only virtue signals, never financially supports. And, you know, that's free advice from RGE. Will companies listen? Well, unfortunately for them, they tend not to. So here we have Yellow Flash. This is from yesterday. Flash posted this clip. Look, NIS America showing off the Switch version of their localization. Basically, that's the summary of the tweet right here. And he plays this clip. I'm not going to play it because copyright and all that. But guess what? I have a transcription here. I did my best to transcribe it. So here's what we got. Person A says, sometimes it will be jokes, Japanese jokes that have different values than we do. Person B, yeah. So things we try to like work around, things that might be a little assist, for example, in Japanese humor with those things, we try to make it more culturally appropriate for our players. Person A, and that doesn't mean it has to be less funny either. Person B, no, not at all. We can work in something even better sometimes. I don't think I need to say much about why a lot of people are taking umbrage with that discourse. I'm preaching to the choir on this one, right? So let's just take a look at some examples of said umbrage. And I got to give credit to Flash because I don't think there was really anyone else, at least that I saw, tweeting about this. So Flash, thanks for bringing this to people's attention. And here's some of the responses now. So NIS America later on made this tweet. We are live now with our first ever NISA news stream. Tune in to twitch.tv NIS America as our Trails of Cold Steel 3 localization editor and translator answer your questions live. Also, stay tuned for awesome giveaways. And the responses, everybody loves this part. This is always the fun part. Let's take a look at how well this went for NISA. I will not be getting a censored game. Why are you changing the dialogue? Why have they done this with every other game? And people just start caring now. I don't agree with what they are doing, but you can't be surprised. Because now people are in a better position to do something about it. Well said. Everyone disliked it, that Fallout meme. You know the one. If you're audio only, it's that Fallout meme. Everyone disliked that. Why did you censor the dialogue? I cannot and will not support a censored game. Censored, huh? Guess I'll keep my money. Shame, though. I'd been looking forward to this game. Censoring and altering dialogue won't entice gamers to part with their money and buy your games. Either release a faithful localization or don't bother. Those who pressure you into censoring material are not the ones who will buy your game. That's a good point. That's kind of in line with what RGE was saying above. Don't change the dialogue. People want to enjoy it in their full glory. They've done this with all their games, though. Plus, so has other companies. A few of us have been saying localization is a type of censorship, and this proves it. But it is a shame people have taken so long to care. This is the same person who said above, like, you can't be surprised, man. I don't know. Like, chill out, man. Chill out. You know, just be glad people are pushing back against it. Come on. Another response? Shame. Who decided you get to be the morality police? Newsflash. The people who buy these games are into these games because of the Japanese culture. And that falls in line with what I said above. Continuing. If you continue to censor and police the original content in this manner, you will lose my support. Nobody wants censored games. Localization should only be used to get the translation as close to the original meaning as possible. Not change the dialogue slash meaning completely to fit another culture's norms. I want the original art flavor from the culture that created it. Not some watered-down misrepresentation. Go work on children's games instead, you prudes. Just straight up. If you don't like the content of this game, why are you the publisher? Modify the story is disrespectful to the original creators. Why don't you guys just translate the Japanese dialogue as is instead of changing what you find offensive? Not everyone gets hurt over what a video game says, you know? Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words can never hurt me. And they add to Nihon Falcom there. So let me get this straight. You guys censored a game without telling people about it? This is the last time I bought a NIS game. I wish I could get a refund for my Trails copy. It goes on for a little bit more, but you guys get the idea. Unfortunately, I don't think Nippon Ichi America will get the idea. I don't know. I got my fingers crossed, but I wouldn't bet money on it. We'll see. I got shoutouts for the very kind people who promoted yesterday's video, and that's going to be Phantom Ravenwood, Ishra Blackwolf, Timothy Hurd, Sharon Young, Andrew Edwards, Code Next, The Lancaster Kid, Anna Senpai, KJ Collins, Jake Beardsley, Spinmaster Rakta, Jordan Avant, and that's it. Thank you all very much for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed this video as well. If you did, consider sharing it, liking it, commenting down below, and all that good stuff. And again, we have that Teespring sale if you're interested. Link in the description to Teespring and that discount code as well. That's all I got for now. I'll see you guys next time. And let me also mention, I think tomorrow I'll be doing a very cool live stream if you're into the Vic Mignogna situation. It'll be a year since Kick Vic got started. The hashtag, it's been a year now since they started doing their weird stuff. But yesterday makes it the hashtag year. So I think we might do something fun. But anyways, more info on that tomorrow. I'll try to tweet the link and what's going on exactly many, many hours before it actually happens, to make it convenient if you can tune in. And if not, well, I'll miss you. We'll miss you. But we'll see you another time. So take care, and I'll catch you then.